Welcome to Tower Talk Business Radio, where we bring you conversations with the top business minds on Long Island and around the nation every week, featuring expert consultants and small business owners who have found success but are also willing to share their top tips, failures, and give gritty, matter-of-fact advice based on their firsthand experience. Now, let's get down to business on Tower Talk Business Radio, on the voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC.
Hello, and welcome to Tower Talk Business Radio, powered by the Nassau Community College Foundation. My name is Ray Schwetz, AVP of Community Relations at Jovia Financial Credit Union, along with Donyshia Boston Hill, CEO, Keeper of the Brand, Marketing, and Digital Agency. And we're focused on being the premier resource for business and entrepreneurship.
We bring you weekly business advice, tips, tools, and services that help you grow your business. Plus, we interview the best in the business, the coolest in the business, and also leaders in the industry. Super excited about this week's show, Ray.
Yep, me too. We have the illustrious Tommy D with us today. Helping provide us with business empowerment is Tommy Dimisa. He's the Director of Strategic Alliances, PEO and HR Division, Vanguard Insurance Agency. Tommy D, welcome to the show.
Listen, guys, this is super exciting for me. I don't know if you know this, but I graduated from Nassau College, so this is like a big deal for me. And that's a long time ago, 1998. So when I used to come to Nassau, there was nowhere to park. So some people might be able to relate to that. There was like a big grass field next to the parking lot. There was never enough car spaces until like 3 weeks into the semester when a lot of people dropped out, and then there was plenty of spots. But I'm psyched to be here with you guys. This is super exciting. I'm ready to roll.
Awesome. I remember those days. Yeah. I graduated in 19. So tell us about yourself, Tommy.
I'm pretty excited about myself, to be honest with you, Ray, and Donyshia. I will tell you, I think you need to be your own biggest fan, and there's no lack of me being my own biggest fan, especially, I mean, sometimes I'll even refer to myself as Tommy D, a little third-person activity, because I think it's cute, it's fun, but the thing about it is, by nature, I'm a connector, so I'm all about bringing people together. So you ever heard that, it was actually in that movie, Ray, I know you like movies, that the movie Office Space, you remember that one?
Oh, sure, yeah.
All right. So he asked him, he said, so what would you do if you won $1 million? Now, if somebody said that to me, I would just have to keep working because I got four kids and I live on Long Island, and that doesn't really mean a whole lot, you know, especially if they're going to tax that $1 million. But let's say I won some significant amount of money where I didn't have to, quote unquote, work anymore. My deal, I would do the exact same thing I do every day, and I'll tell you about that in a second, but I would just be connecting people. I would get together. I mean, back when we were allowed to get together in person, now I'm living on Zoom like a lot of us are, but I just put people together. You know, I see opportunities where business people, when you bring people together, I don't think 2 + 2 = 4. I think it equals some exponential number. So I'm passionate about connecting people and bringing them together. So if I didn't have to do the thing, sell the business, whatever the case may be, and I could just connect all day, a couple of things would change. I wouldn't wear shirts and ties. Make a note, I haven't worn dress shoes in 6 months.
Woo!
So big deal. Super excited. Flip-flops only. Even when I go for my walk in the morning, just flip-flops. But I would just wear Hawaiian shirts and kukui nuts, and I would just make connections with people. And it's because I just got fired up about it a long time ago. I've been networking before I knew it was called networking. I just thought it made sense because this person does that and you do something that's complimentary. We should all sit at a bar and talk about that. And I didn't know that was networking. I just thought that was obvious. So so that's what I'm passionate about. Well, you want to know about me, really? I four kids, live here on the island with my wife, Christine, and these four kids. And our business, we're in the employee benefits business. I do a lot of work in the nonprofit sector. Love nonprofits, specifically those that serve the intellectually and developmentally disabled. There's some stories behind that. We get to it. Family Foundation, Lindy Lou, in memory of my cousin Linda, and all the money that we raise from that organization goes to serve the special needs community. So it's a sore spot in our heart, and it's really in the DNA of our firm as well.
Nice. So how long have you been in the field of insurance and working with Vanguard? Tell us a little bit about how that happened and how you landed in that space.
So it's a pretty cool story because I used to work for a company called Automatic Data Processing, large payroll company. Most people have heard of it. I was a bartender before that when I was growing up, which maybe for my personality, you get that would be like the right scene for me to be in. But I spent a lot of years at the end of high school and through college working in a bar business. And after that, I went and worked for ADP, And I didn't really know about networking. This is like 2003. So I Googled, if there was Google, I did something, but I found the Bayside Business Association, which now all these years later, 17 years later, I'm on the board. But why this story is important is in 2003, I actually met these two guys, Ed Probst and Vince Blasi, who are now partners of mine in business with the Vanguard Insurance Agency. So they had founded this firm, Vanguard, in 1999. So we're a 21-year-old boutique insurance benefits firm. We said probably 16 years ago that we would eventually be in business together, and it didn't actually happen. It happened, sort of evolved through the years, because as sometimes entrepreneurs become employees, although it's not always the best place for us, but there's things that pull us into jobs and things like that. So I oftentimes had those types of jobs, but always had this relationship with Ed and Vinny. And about 4 years ago is when it became a real situation. We really decided at that point too, when I came on board, that we were going to have a major focus in serving nonprofits. So it's sort of in the DNA of the firm. We love to work with those types of organizations who are what we call employers of choice. And what that really means to us is those sort of organizations or businesses, and this usually is from top down. They care about their people. They care about their associates. They want to make sure that they're delivering a great culture, great benefit packages, an environment where people want to come to work. And I think as we sit here 6 months into this quarantine pandemic situation, I think one of the major challenges for businesses is how do we have that culture? How do we keep that culture? How do we protect our associates with the challenges around mental illness that is hitting a lot of folks right now? It was before, but even more so now. So that's, we're in those conversations a lot. But I think from an impact perspective, what I think we're real good at is finding out what an organization is trying to accomplish and helping them utilize benefits to do that. So benefits meaning health insurance and other ancillary benefits.
What is that, like, the common misconception about the work that you do?
I guess, you know, being that we're in the benefits business and we're consulting with organizations, I think some people don't realize, business owners, how important this can be to the employees and their families. So it's an expensive endeavor. What I'm really saying there, right, is if a company isn't paying a substantial amount, contributing a substantial amount to their employees' benefits, this can be a very costly conversation for people. So I think there has to be some strategy around that, where the employer group is mindful of this can be a real tough scenario for employees to pay for health insurance. So they have to often make different concessions and strategize in different ways. And I think a lot of what we're able to do is, you know, it's not just the health insurance is what it is, the numbers are what they are. There's creative ways, and that's a lot of what we do, is bring in strategies and concepts for our clients. There's creative ways to offset different costs and to bring in different strategies. And I think that's what makes us, aside from that, we're real big on employee education. So when we meet with a new group and we're onboarding their employees, we do one-on-one education up front. And then what we'll do throughout the year is one of my partners, Vinny, runs all of our operations and client service division. So they'll get access to Vinny and his team to really answer any questions throughout the year. Things like, I have an explanation of benefits I don't understand, or I need to get prior authorization for a procedure I want to have done. And that stuff can be rather technical, and it's not something that everyday people who don't play with this and work with this every day deal with. So I think the major thing that we offer to our clients and their employees is that handholding and that one-on-one consultation. I think it's been a big difference for us.
You are listening to Tower Talk Business Radio on the voice of Nash Community College, 90.3 WHPC. I'm Ray Schwetz, along with Donyshia Boston Hill, and our guest today is Tommy Dimisa, Director of Strategic Alliances, PEO and HR Division, Vanguard Insurance Agency. What are some of the challenges? I mean, you alluded to it before. Obviously, what you love about what you do is reaching out and touching people, getting to know them. What has been the biggest challenge for you during this whole pandemic situation?
Well, there's a lot of challenges, I think, for a lot of us, Ray. But I mean, if you want to know specifically what's hit me the hardest is it's strange not to see people, man. Like, I'm used to, how many times have we used to see each other at events? I was telling somebody this morning, there's times in my networking running around Long Island when I would hit like two or three events in the same night, which in retrospect was kind of crazy and maybe wasn't necessary, but it certainly helped me build a brand for a guy who was running around connecting all the time. So the fact that I'm playing golf on Monday, it's the first time I'll be in any sort of business setting. I don't know if we talk about dates here, but it's been 6 months since I've been in a client type of situation or a business partner situation. So playing golf in an outing on Monday. And that, to me, is exciting. But at the same time, it's a little bit of anxiety around it. I actually talked to a buddy of mine from the Queen's Chamber of Commerce earlier, and he invited me to dinner next Tuesday night, and I'm going to go. But I don't know how to interact with people anymore, Ray. I don't remember. Like, I've had friends of mine, like neighborhood friends in the backyard, you know, whatever. We order some Chinese food, and we sit far apart from each other while we eat Chinese food together. But it's like for me, you know this, we know each other. I love people. And I have these people in my house that I love, and that's great. But it's been strange for me. But I will tell you what I've learned, which is I would not have thought would have actually been true. I'm on Zoom all day like a lot of us are, right? I mean, Zoom or GoToMeeting or whatever, but I tend to be on the Zoom a lot. And I think what's kind of shocked me, and I've become a member of some different communities, and I've never met these people in real life. I've never held their hand or gave them a hug or exchanged a business card. But over the last 6 months, I've become friends with people. And like, that to me is strange. Like, it's cool. I love it. But it's, to me, it's not something that I would have said. I guess it makes sense. Like, people have pen pals and stuff like that. And people who never met end up becoming romantically involved. But for me, I was like, no, you got to be out there. You got to see the people. You got to shake hands and the whole thing. So that to me has been strange, but at the same time, it's been awesome because it's opened up new opportunity for me and opened up new ideas for me just to consider that we don't have to be in the same room. Now, we'll see how that all shakes out. I mean, I will tell you what the major benefit for me in that regard is. I never used to see my kids during the week. Never. Like, I would leave early in the morning and come home late at night. And that was like kind of matter of fact. It was like, not that I didn't want to see them, but it was kind of how we set up the labor distribution here at the house, and that I was going to go out and be the chief revenue officer, and my wife was going to be chief everything else. And that was kind of how it went down. But that's changed. And I'm telling you this, and I'm sure there's a lot of dads and moms that had similar scenarios like that. I'm not going back to what it was March 11th. That ship has sailed. That game is over. So where people talk about that whole going back to normal, which we used to say, you know, back in April or May, we used to say like going back to normal, like that whole thing's gone, man. So in my scenario, it's like, I'm not going there again. I realized our business is growing. Our clients are happy. Mentally, I'm pretty good. Mental health is good being home. I told you, I haven't put on anything but flip-flops in like 6 months. And that's just good. You know, I like to feel the grass beneath my feet when I go outside. So I'm totally jazzed about that. So the challenge has been like, I don't get to connect with people in the real form. But I think the other side of that coin is that it's been really cool to connect with people online. And let's be honest, I'm sure you guys can agree, this is a super efficient way, this whole Zoom thing. Like, I didn't have to drive to a diner. I didn't have to drive to a restaurant. I didn't have to drive, period. And, you know, I literally just grab my coffee, come up two flights of stairs here to the attic, and it's business time. So that's a game changer.
I love it. And so let me ask you, so that sounds like you is the new Tommy D culture for, you know, moving forward with business. Kind of a little bit of live, a little bit of hybrid, little Hawaiian shirt I'm seeing. What do you think, you know, how are you going to evolve as you, you know, look forward?
Yeah, listen, I say this to be cute, but I mean it. Every day, Donyshia, I'm just trying to be the best Tommy D I can be. And I mean that because I instill in my kids that, you know, like we're constantly evolving as human beings. We're just trying to get better every day, right? So, yeah, I think it'll be – I love that word used there, hybrid, because I think that's where we're going. I mean, we run a networking group that so we had two communities of this networking group going into March. And now last night we launched a group in Boston. So now we have 8 groups, all virtual, all on Zoom, high level. Guests get suggested. It's a vetted community. Everybody's a connector who shows up. It's kind of a, you know, an elevated mentality. And people have been asking as they're joining these groups, they go, so where are we going to meet in Boston? I said, we're not there yet. Like, it's not even, we're doing everything on Zoom, which has been incredible. And people are conducting business across different territories. You know, people down in South Florida are doing business up here in New York, and people out of Chicago are connecting with people in Atlanta. So it's different than what it was, but I think those are some of the major benefits. I don't want to say there's benefits to what we're going through, but there are positive outcomes. And as the three of us have probably heard, there are businesses being built. There are ideas that are starting. There are communities that are being created. You know, as a result of people being industrious and taking chances. And Donyshia, I was listening to something, a podcast that you were on the It Girl earlier today. You know, it's just, you know, you talk a lot about the entrepreneurs and you know, how you got to put yourself out there, make calculated risks, but put yourself out there, take chances. And I think these times create those opportunities for people.
No, absolutely. And Tommy, I'll tell you, you know, we talk about the positive outcome of this, right? This has started, you mentioned that you have, you know, 8 different chapters in different cities, but I really think, and Ray, you probably can attest, that working from home or being virtual at one time was a faux pas. People were truly like, oh my goodness, what do you mean? Where's your office? Where, you know, what's happening? And now you can work across state lines. You can work across international lines. You can pick up the phone. You can jump on Zoom. And you're not scared anymore, you know? So, you know, you're not technology, you know, handicapped, I would say. So that's so great that you're doing that. But what do you think? What's hopeful for you in business moving forward?
I think there's a lot of things to be hopeful about. I think just, I want to go back to what you said real quick there about, you know, people have been working remotely forever. And to your point, though, it hasn't been an across-the-board scenario, but we've proved out, proof of concept, that this thing actually works, and people are being super productive and, in a lot of cases, more productive. What I'm hopeful about is early what I said earlier. I think people are finding opportunities. People are taking chances. You hear some negative things about New York City and you know, you'll hear a lot of things if you listen to in the wrong places, I guess. But I think as a society, as humans, man, we move, we shake, we make things happen. I go back to another movie and was Shawshank, and he says, you know, get busy living or get busy dying. And that's a little rude, but it's real. You know, I think you have to just keep evolving and get better. So I'm excited about, look, I got 4 little kids that are coming home from school shortly. And, you know, I'm excited about what they're going to do in this world. And, you know, a lot of what I do philanthropically, I think impacts, I don't think, I know it. I mean, I didn't do it, what I do in the nonprofit space, aside from serving clients, but what we do, you know, in volunteer work and things, I didn't do it necessarily to just say, I'm doing this to impact my kids. But here's what I'll tell you. My oldest came home like 3 years ago and she told me she joined the community service club. And a year and a half later, she told me she was the president of the community, or she says, I need you to help me with this application. I want to be the president of the community service club. So I think I've impacted in some way there. You know, when I'm at an event for Best Buddies and I'm scooping Italian ice, you know, my parents, I got to give them a shout out. They own the Italian ice store, Ralph's out in Huntington. So they're always hooking me up, whether they know it or not. Sometimes they don't know I'm taking ices from them, but that's another story. But I go to these events and I'm scooping ices. And my son, he said to me one day, he goes, somebody, you have to do this thing. You know how like it's like Father's Day and you have like 5 questions. Like, my dad likes ice cream. We root for the Mets, you know, stuff like that. And he was like, my dad works for Best Buddies. Now, I don't work for Best Buddies, but he had been at enough events with me, scooping ices and things like that, and it impacts them. So that's what fires me up, is I didn't do it because of that, but I'll continue to do what I'm doing because it inspires their stuff. And Ray, shout out to you, because I've seen some of the stuff with your daughters on, I know, with like what they're doing from a volunteer perspective. And I'll tell you, my parents are great people, but we weren't necessarily like volunteers growing up. I just somehow got drawn to this sector. And I got to tell you, don't tell your listeners, but it actually makes you feel good. So it's a little selfish. So it's a little bit selfish. It's not just being selfless. It's when, you know, especially in the communities that we serve in the IDD space, and you can make an impact for people like that. I think, you know, I'm 42 now, and if you met me 12 years ago, different guy, right? Always evolving. But like, I just believe we're actually here to add value and make an impact. The rest of it, I'm not really sold on materialistic stuff. Like, it's nice. Like, it's nice to have a nice car, but, like, I like my Nissan Sentra. Gets me where I got to go, and I roll it back into the dealership every 3 years, and they give me another Nissan Sentra. So, I mean, I don't get too caught up with that stuff. But if you can make an impact and help people, I know there's people growing up, like, in my life where I remember just a smile from somebody on a down. I literally remember, like, I was going to college in the city for a time, and I was on the subway, and I was feeling kind of down, and, you know, like, a young person just smiled at me, and, like, you literally change somebody's game. You change their day by the impact you have on them. And maybe people are listening to this, and maybe there's maybe that impacts them, and maybe it inspires them to do some service, or you know, I'll tell you, when I was in high school, I didn't even remember this. I haven't told this story in 20 years. Like, I was part of a group that used to collect, like, canned food. Like, I didn't even remember I did it until I was actually having this conversation with you guys. But, like, it's the little stuff that we do, like, that might seem like it's no big deal. I don't know, man, changes people's stars.
You are listening to Tower Talk Business Radio. Our guest today is Tommy DeMosa, Director of Strategic Alliance, PEO and HR Division, Vanguard Insurance Agency. My name is Donyshia Boston Hill, along with Ray Schwetz on the voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC.
I think you've taught us a few things, you know, in a short period of time. What do you feel like? I feel like you've learned a lot doing the work that you do. So, what do you think is the most important thing that you've learned in doing the business that you do?
So here's the thing, Ray. There's a certain point in your life, or in all of our lives, when I think you can stop hanging out with people who, I'm going to just say this word, I don't think we need to hang out with people who suck. Sorry if that's a bad word. But I just don't think we have to. Like, growing up, like, maybe you got to do certain things. And, you know, especially in my profession in sales, you have to engage with people who might not, you know, be great. But I just think, like, God, man, there's so many people to connect with. Just connect with the cool ones. Connect with people who want to give, who want to collaborate. You know, the we thing, not the me thing. I think that's the biggest thing to take away in life, and try to add value. Like, whatever that means. I mean, I tell you, I do a lot of networking, but to me, it's about making deposits into relationships. And really, there's tons of books out there on this stuff, you know, Go Giver, et cetera, whatever. The thing is, though, like, I just hook people up with really, honestly, no expectation that something specifically is going to come back from that relationship. So I think if we could be more focused on the other instead of just kind of caught up on ourselves and realize, and, you know, I do a lot of self-reflection. And like I say, I'd say kind of tongue in cheek, trying to be the best Tommy D. But honestly, it's just that. It's like trying to figure out how I can be better for other people. Because honestly, let's be honest, we're all really connected, like, at a deeper level at the end of the day. So if you're hooking other people up, aren't you hooking yourself up, and we're all sort of working together? And if we kind of row in the same direction, I think we win.
No, I agree. And so, Tommy, can you just share with us, you know, how do you balance that? You know, earlier you said you have to be your own biggest fan.
Yeah.
So, like me, totally self-absorbed in my own world, business owner, and some of our listeners out there as well, you know, how do you balance that?
Look, half of it's tongue in cheek. It's a little swag, right? We know I'm having fun with it, but like at the end of the day, you know, some of it is the charm, and I turn it on. But it's good to have a little ego. People like it; they chuckle at it, you know. But I how do I balance it? I find ways where I can make other people connect with people where I think they're going to be better. It doesn't always mean business. It means, like, I have a friend who is a professional musician, and I can hook her up with nonprofit organizations. So there's no business necessarily being transacted, but both parties are better. Or I have a friend who's an artist, and I know another person who's into art, and we go to their gallery opening back in the day when we were allowed to go into buildings and not have masks on, et cetera, et cetera. But like, I'm just trying to have a good time, Donyshia, you know, like just trying to have fun, just trying to, most of what I'm saying is really because I think it entertains other people. I know it entertains me. And I think it's like, I think that's one of the, I don't know if it's superpower, man, but I think it's an ability that I have. I remember growing up in sales, and like, I'm there to sell payroll, and people were telling me about like their lives. And I think there's certain people in our society that I don't know, people just connect. People just feel comfortable. I would get stories out of people and I wasn't asking. But I think it's because I know what it is. I'm genuinely interested in, like, other people. Like, there's a Brian Tracy or Tom Hopkins. I don't remember which it was. But there was a old school, like, sales trainers. And there was a thing there where they said it's more important to be an interested introvert than an interesting extrovert, right? Because if you could just dig other people and totally like vibe with them, which is so funny because when we talked earlier, I said, how am I going to talk about myself? Because I just want to ask Ray and Donyshia what they're all about, because I don't want it to be about Tommy D. I want to ask you guys what the deal is. So it's that. It's just I just love other people's stories, and I get high off that. I really do. I have fun with it. So we find that balance, I guess, whatever that is. I mean, I'm barely perfect. I mean, I'm just trying to be great, you know? So I have fun with it.
Well, you know, it's, I think it goes back to, you have to be your own biggest fan because you want to have very positive thoughts in your head because you want to be the best that you can be, the best you that you can be, because then you want to help other people. And it's hard to help other people if you're not being the best that you can be. So at least that's what I'm getting out of the conversation with you.
I would agree with you, right? You know, like, you know, the first choice everybody makes, like, you know, I love to get on a call at 7 o'clock in the morning and I go, so, hey, how you doing? And the person's like, friggin' awesome. Everything's like, I'm like, I love that. I love that conversation. And I'm usually that guy to the other person, because when somebody says, I'm like, that's awesome. Because you made that decision that morning to say, I'm awesome. Everything's great. You know, versus, you know, what do some people say? You know, hanging in there, really? Like, yeah, you made a choice and that's what you went with, hanging in there? Come on, man. It's freaking awesome. It's great. Life's so cool. And that sounds like I see the world through rose-colored glasses, and I don't even wear glasses, but I see the world as opportunity, and there's so much fun stuff that you can see. And I'll tell you a quick story. I don't know how much time we have left. I'll tell you a quick story. Let me tell you this one. Somebody said,
gotta make it really quick.
Somebody said, I said one time, right? I said, I'm going to make a long story short. And they go, Tommy D, you don't even know how to make a long story short. So I'll just make a long story longer. But I met this guy. I was selling payroll in Jamaica, Queens. And I went up to the second story of the building. And this man was probably like, at the time, maybe 50. And he was so like excited about life. And he was like frustrated that there was so much he wasn't going to be able to learn. He wasn't passing away, but he just realized he had 40, 50 years left of life. And his thing was, I'm not going to get to learn at all. So that's, I think, what should drive people. And that's the fun. And that's the little thing that I get to create with my children, their version of the future. And I think that helps. That's what I can bring to them. Is I'm loving that they're going to listen to this on the radio. And that's going to be so fun, you know, because, you know, they get excited about that. They're big Tommy D fans.
And Ray, today, that's DB's philosophy.
I love it. I love it. Well, Tommy, thank you very much for being with us. Give us your contact information.
Yeah, so this is something I do on my videos, and people think I'm out of my mind. 516-492-4928. That's my cell phone. Call me. Send me a text message. Or you can always get me at email, tdimisa, T-D-I-M-I-S-A, at vgdny.com. You know, obviously LinkedIn, and you'll find me on those other places as well. But just let's connect, man. Thanks so much for having me on the show. This was really fun, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. It was great to have you on. We want to thank you for being with us. My name is Ray Schwetz, along with Donyshia Boston Hill, your co-host and producers. This is an NCC Foundation Business Leaders Council production. Visit ncc.edu/WHPC for more information. Available on iHeartRadio as a podcast on iTunes, Android Podcasts, and Spreaker. This has been Tower Talk Business Radio on the voice of Nass Community College 90.3 WHPC.